an era in which we are questioning the effectiveness of markets in producing the kind of society and economy we want to live in, it is more important than ever to have an objective debate about the role that markets and the state play in the economy. Is the state necessary only to correct market failures, or is it also needed to more actively shape and create markets and technological opportunities, and to promote growth which is not only smart, but also inclusive?
The term socialization of investment is due to Keynes in the last pages of the general theory. I think it is a very important notion, especially in the way it was interpreted again by Hyman Minsky. Hyman Minsky was a pupil of Schumpeter, and what was interesting in him is that he had a kind of stage view of the capitalist development, but he inserted Keynesian themes in this perspective. Now, if we take a long-term view of capitalist development, we may say that for a while a driver of capitalist growth was investment, and especially the Schumpeterian innovators' investment. That, however, became less and less so in the 20th century, meaning that after the crisis of the 30s of last century, it was clear that there was a problem of effective demand and of mass unemployment, which could not be resolved just with the going towards the dynamism of the entrepreneurs. It was needed an intervention of the state and of the government, government with ex-ante planned deficits. And this was, in a sense, the way it was taken by capitalist economies, especially with the war, Second World War, and after the Second World War. In his great book of the 36, The General Theory, Keynes was saying that actually to resolve the problems of capitalism, insufficiency of effective demand and insufficient employment, it was needed a socialization of investment. This meant an increased share of government expenditure in the economy, let us say doing useful things. But Keynes also said that after we arrived to full employment, the market as an allocator of resources is okay. It is from here that it's interesting to understand Minsky. Minsky, since the 70s, was critical of the really existing Keynesianism, meaning the way of resolving the crisis through pump priming and high investment, high profits economy, nurturing the rise of finance. In his way of thinking, Minsky said that, yes, in this way we may resolve the crisis of effective demand, but with non-targeting the spending and reproducing a huge instability in the process. The way out was a much more radical than Keynes' socialization of investment. This meant socializing banking and finance, socializing employment, and having the state intervene in the level and composition of output. What I think Minsky had in mind was a kind of Keynesian New Deal. The historical New Deal was not really Keynesian. Roosevelt was against actually deficit spending, but in another sense it was more radical than what came to be known as Keynesian, because the state intervened directly, directing a targeted spending, defining even somehow the composition of output on the side of supply, with the state being an employer of last resort. This was the line that Minsky was taking in his thinking, and we now realize that this idea of socialization investment is more and more important with the crisis of neoliberalism. Neoliberalism, I think, must be understood, as Minsky did, as a money manager capitalism. And this money manager capitalism actually was based on a kind of miracle. After the attack on the Keynesian era by Volcker, Reagan and Thatcher, which meant high rate of interest, decrease of investments, attack on the welfare and government spending, of course there was the risk of it happening again, of the great crash coming back again. Because of course the solution of individual countries finding markets with net exports is not available on the world scale. The miracle of neoliberalism was to connect the market capital inflation, the increase of capital asset prices to collateralized lending, which was able to drive an increase in consumption, indebted consumption. And this indebted consumption was managed by a new kind of monetary policy. This meant a shift from the orientation by the government and somehow public debt towards an increasing private debt, especially household debt. This was very unstable, and this house of cards collapsed first with the dot-com crisis 2000, 2002, 2003. But second, more definitely, with the subprime crisis since 2007 until now. So the problem is which way out, what can be the driver of growth? And I think it cannot but be government spending. But this government spending can't be, in my way, the old Keynesian non-targeted way of spending. It must be a spending in socially useful activities producing wealth more than just value or monetary appreciation of assets. And it is here that the discourse of Minsky with a productive public spending, which the state intervenes more and more, but changing somehow the way people consume is important. Minsky was for a high consumption economy, but high consumption meant going out from a way of consumerism destructive of the environment. This means that the state must go in, the government must go in, driving the long run horizon of investment. So the state is also crucial for creating a true new innovative economy. This means having the possibility to fully exploit the communications technology, but also going towards a real new green economy.